In this course, we explored fundamental typologies of compressible waves and the mathematical theories to analyze them. We used a one-dimensional model to derive the normal shock relations that describe the variation of fluid properties such as pressure, density, and temperature across a normal shock. We also learned about how we can express the normal shock conditions in terms of thermodynamic variables only through Rankine-Huguenot relation. Then we learned about oblique shocks and their properties. We derived mathematical relations to describe them combining the normal shock relations with simple trigonometry. We analyzed how different geometries generate and affect the oblique shocks and obtain an understanding of limiting cases such as detached shocks, where an analytical solution cannot be obtained. We learned that Bose shocks can be seen as a blend of all the shock solutions from normal shock wave to the Mach wave. Lastly, we also explored the expansion waves that occurs when a flow turns around a corner. We learned that expansion waves actually accelerate the fluid instead of slowing it down, like the shocks do. And then we derived the Prandtl-Meyer equation, allowing us to estimate how the fluid Mach number would change due to a given deflection angle in the geometry. With this knowledge of shock expansion theory, we are now ready to analyze more complex scenarios involving compressible waves.